se pare că nu te pot nici reața.
Se pare că ne casim, ne rei,
de bărin. First of all, I have the pleasure.
Nu te pot nici reața.
Ne casim, ne rei, ne mave.
The great honor. To thank
Shtetet e Bashkuarat Amerikës.
United States of America.
Congresul American.
The American Congress.
Opinion Progressive American.
The public opinion of America.
Dhe gjithë shtypin amerikan.
The American press.
Që me aq miredashse, me aq humanizëm u angazhuar për fatin tim.
Which in a humanitarian way was engaged on my destiny.
Të gjithë i falenderoj nga zemra.
I thank you heart.
Historia tregoi.
History tells us
se nuk ka popull të vogël dhe popull të madh.
That there is no small nation or big nation.
Por ka popull civilizues, human.
There are civilized nations.
Dhe ka popull barbar.
And barbarian nations.
Populli shqiptar i takon popujve të civilizimit.
The Albanian people belongs to the civilized people. So.
Shqiptarët këtë e kanë treguar gjatë gjithë historisë.
The Albanians have proved this during the course of history.
Sepse kurën e kurës asken s'kanë përdosur, nuk kanë shkelur dhe nuk kanë sakatosur.
Because they never submitted anyone, they never maltreated anyone.
Për kundërzi, ne kemi dhënë prova të larta të një shoqërie civilizuese humanitare.
Quite the opposite, we proved to be a greatly civilized nation.
I kemi dhënë vlera të larta historisë së përbashkëme dhe kulturës së përbashkëme.
We gave lots of contribution to the world history and to the European history.
Është e vështirë të gjenësh vetë në vend në botë ku nuk do gjenet një person, një figur që nuk ka prejardhje shqiptare.
It is difficult to find a country where there were no important Albanian figures.
Tashti, me që unë në mënyrë brutale, në mënyrë arbitrare dhe shumë primitive, u privova nga një drejtë elementale të të gjenet në Amerikë,
after I was denied in a brutal way my coming to America,
do të them disa fjalë.
I would say a few words.
Jo për shkeljen e të drejtave të njeriut në Kosovë.
Not on the violation of human rights in Kosovo.
Sepse ato nuk ekzistojnë fare.
Because these rights do not exist at all.
Por do të flas për një terror shtetëror.
But I would speak of a state terror.
Që përpara ushtronte Jugoslavia,
which Jugoslavia exercised.
Dhe tani ushtron Serbia.
And now is being exercised by Serbia.
Do të flasim me gjuhën e fakteve.
I will speak with the language of facts.
Por derisa ne po i fitshim mesafirët tanë të ndëruar nga Amerika,
while we were expecting our guests from America, respected guests from America,
pikrisht para hotelit Grand,
in front of the Grand Hotel,
policia maltretoi qytetarët shqiptar,
the police abused and maltreated Albanian,
arrestoi dy persona,
arrested two persons,
ekë detosh qytetarë,
and this was one of them, was the killer.
Një djalosh e rrahu në qendër të Prishtinës.
One young man was beaten up in the center of Prishtinë.
Është një detaj që flet shumë.
This is only a detail that speaks by itself.
Sepse në Kosovë,
because in Kosovo,
nuk funksionon sistemi juridik.
There is no judicial system working.
Nuk funksionon shteti.
State is not functioning.
Nuk sundon ligja dhe kushtetuta.
There is no law or constitution.
Por sundon terrori i tmerrshëm.
But only terrible terror.
Prandaj unë në emër të Këshillit,
and on behalf of the council,
ftoj të gjitha forcat progresive botërore,
I call to all the progressive forces of
the world, që të denojnë në mënyrë më të ashpër këtë terror shtetëror mbi popullsinë shqiptare në Kosovë dhe jashtë Kosovës,
to punish this unprecedented terror which is being exercised against the Albanian population.
Nuk kemi kohë.
We do not have time.
Ja srebran sistemi juridik Kosovo.
This is an example of the judicial system working in Kosovo.
Personi që lutën.
The person who was traveling.
Shqiptar.
Albanian.
Me trenin Belgrad për Kosovë.
In the train going from Belgrade to.
Rahat me tren në mënyrë barbare.
Was beaten in the train in the most barbarous way.
A Libanoset.
He lost conscious.
Në një këtë gjendje arrin në fushë Kosovë.
And in this condition he arrived to Kosovo.
Dëmtojmë informacionin ju në angleze.
We will be representing our guest and information, a report from our council.
Me fakte të gjalla.
Has facts about the most recent cases of maltreatment.
Qytetarë shqiptarë në Kosovë.
Albanian citizens in Kosovo.
Mund të vriten në të shastë.
May be killed at every moment.
Mund të flagosen.
They can be wounded.
Mund të triven.
They can be castrated.
Organe genitale.
The genitals.
Dhe askush nuk jep përgjegjësi.
And nobody does anything about it.
Dhe prap se prap thuhet.
And they still say.
Se shqiptar janë terrorista.
That the Albanians are.
Fundamentalista.
Fundamentalists.
Edhe me varë tjera e për të shumëtuara.
And by number of other labels.
Deri me sot, për gjitha këto vrasje mizore.
Up to now.
Plagosje.
All these killings and.
Bastisje.
Searches.
Rrahje.
Beatings.
Nuk është ngritur asnjë kallëzim penal ndaj aktorëve të policisë që i ka bërë të
vepra. No one has been taken to court. Accused of this.
Dhe shqiptari që ngrit vetëm dy gishta.
But the Albanian who as much as raises two fingers.
Rrahat, maltretohet.
Is beaten, maltreated.
Dhe dënohet nga gjykata aty për aty.
And is punished by the courts at the spot.
Kemi edhe materiale filmike.
We have other documents, films.
E përvojnë këte i
përvojnë,
po do t'i kemi rrasën në shumë.
And I think we will have the chance later.
Qështja me eklatante është elmini i popullsisë shqiptare.
The most extreme case is the poisoning, the intoxication of the Albanian.
Nga kjo sëmurje, deri tani e përfshin mbi 6,000 qytetarë.
Until now, more than 6,000 people, mainly school children, were intoxicated.
Dhe organet zyrtare Jugoslave dhe Serbe.
The official Jugoslav and Serbian organs.
Thonë që shqiptarët simulojnë smunjen.
Say that the Albanians are simulating.
Si mund të helmon 6,000 qytetarë?
How can 6,000 people be intoxicated?
Nga vetë vetëja.
By themselves.
Me me dje që këshili kvartetat dhe rritën e jutë, në slimi përshkim, për ndërë të miqve tanë të ndërru nga Amerika.
We have a statement to make here in honor of our guest, our consul has decided.
Sonte në ora 8, mërëndë.
Tonight at 8 o'clock this evening.
Shtronë dark.
We organized a dinner
in the restaurant in Dubrovnik.
In Dubrovnik restaurant.
Kemi knasin që për pos këshillit komplet që kam e qenë këtu, të frasim Adem Demacin, Femi Agani, Ibrahim Rogovën, Vleta Kullën, Harald Agaranin, Hivzi Islamin, Jusuf Bojovin, Shëzën Malicin dhe Wilber Wissel. Beton në rrëva, beton se rrohin këtë këmë në pashme.
Në dojë gohë, dojë. Të në dojë, në dojë të jabon dhe lasja, në shërën në dojë, në dojë,
se më dhëmë të Safja, ndërojë të gjithat Amerikanë të cilët janë marë dhe janë përgjegjës për gjerimit.
I would like to thank all those Americans which were engaged and did something about my release.
Në shtëpinë time kam me mia Katolina e letra që më kanë ardhur.
At home I have thousands of postcards with postcards. which supported me and encouraged me during my stay in the prison. And I would ask you kindly to transmit my thanks and gratitude for this. I have done nothing especially heroic. I have done my duty, which was laid down before me by the elected. But dying for my people a thousand times, I would still say that this is very little. I don't think that only my people is a heroic people. I would like to say, my dear friends, that the Serbian people is also a very heroic
people.
And the support you are giving to us, you should give it to the Serbian people as
well.
This policy which is being implemented from the is not supported by the Serbian people. Because it is also oppressed just by the way we are. And even Yugoslavia, which tolerates this policy, is not free. And I want to be sure that by supporting us, you are also supporting the Serbian people to free itself from this parasite class. And that this part of Yugoslavia to come to the democratic
process.
With all these horrible things you heard from my friend Mr. Cana, my people, which is suffering, but which is very heroic, is always ready to work and cooperate with all of the rest of the peoples, including the Serbian people. You witnessed this heroism which was shown by our people. Even though it took continuous beatings, it did not return back any of these beatings. Even though they killed our children, even though they insulted us, even though they beat us, even though they beat our mothers and fathers, our homes,
the
people had the power to endure, so that not respond to evil with evil, but with love. Therefore, we need to have good understanding
of
the Serbian people, so that you shouldn't mix the Serbian people with those who have the power. So I would ask you are helping all of us, not only the
others.
We would all like to be to get rid of these police and create a general climate
in
Bulgaria, in the Balkans, and in Europe, which will make it possible for us to live equal, free, and as it is fit to the country.
Ja porcilni kongresit amerikan konsiderata te mia
relata to carry my deep appreciation to the Congress of America
per angazhimin e ti
for its engagement
per demokraci
for democracy
per diri
for freedom
per bashkullim
for cooperation,
për dashuri,
për love,
për humanism,
and humanity.
Ju falenderit edhe një herë që ne keni ardhur, na keni pasur.
Thank you very much once again for coming to see us.
Thank you.
Before we go on to Mr. Saroy, I would like to just interrupt for a minute.
Para se të vazhdojmë me zotin Saroy, do të ndërpreja vetëm për një moment.
Because earlier I was able to extend my good friend Zekeri Atsana an official invitation from Congressman Lantos and the Congressional Human Rights Foundation to come to America soon, I hope, because he wants to have you in Washington and I want to have you in New York. But I offer now the same invitation to Adem Damachi and Sabahate Cheshari. Cheshari?
Cheshari?
Yeah. So that you both have official invitations. One of the most immediate tests of the sincerity of the Serbian Republic and Yugoslavia to see whether they have joined the human race and are civilized is to see how fast now you come to the United States. Because I assume you're going to get your passports right away. We'll be looking at that. You can be sure of it, Congressman Lantos.
Me pare I dorëzora një ftesë të zotrit Zonë, cili nuk pati mundësi të vi në Washington, dhe kjo është ftesa personale që I bërë nga kongresmeni Lantos, dhe tash po ashtu dorëzoj ftesën zotri Zemaqës dhe bashkëshortës e ti që të vinë në kongresin Amerikan dhe të prezentojnë para fondacionit drejta dhe të njeri, dhe fakti se në që mënyrë dhe sa shpet do të lejoj qëllëria Jugoslave pasportat që të ndonjë atje do të dëshmoj se a vendon vërtet në procesin e demokratizimit.
Mrs. Lantos, Mr. and Mrs. Lantos.
Taglisht.
Dr. King, Joe. It is a difficult task to speak about the situation after a man who has spent 28 years in prison and who finds words of love. But I think he gives a general feeling of the whole non-violent movement, of the whole movement for democracy, that even though going through violence, feeling violence as something you have to live through every day, you still have to find a hope and you still have to find words of love, because that is the only way to go through this purgatory, I would say. It is, of course, difficult to speak now, being one of the first, or the first representative of the first organization, and on the other side being the last one who came to the United States and couldn't come to Washington, unfortunately. But I would give you, since I represent a Yugoslav organization, an organization that has branches through the whole country, I think it would be good to situate Kosovo and its crisis within Yugoslavia's reform, Yugoslavia's trend to parliamentary democracy. As you have seen, we live in the south, we live in the totalitarian south, whereas our north has gone through its pre-elections and is going, or it's pushing for federal election in which all of us would be represented in the freely elected Yugoslav parliament. Yugoslavia still hasn't made a step or the necessary step to feel free or to feel sure that it will make these elections possible. We still live on a brink of repressive movement or something that could be the last Stalinist state in Europe. As you know, we do live, or the Albanian population, the Albanian people as a whole, live under the two repressive totalitarian regimes, one in Serbia and the other one in Albania. If we could make it possible to make some breakthroughs here, and obviously some breakthroughs are needed in Albania, then we would be speaking of at least in a democratic initiative united people. But I would concentrate still on Serbia and its problems, and Kosovo, obviously, and the regime that lives there. In the three branches of life, we are living the deepest crisis. Politically, we are under a clear police domination. We live under a police occupation of Kosovo by Serbian police forces. Economically, there is a movement towards annexation of all the all the companies that could eventually work in a market economy. And as far as conditions in the Federation are concerned, we live under what is what or what tends to be an annexation, of, a clear annexation of Kosovo under the Serbian constitution. Our response will obviously be one of resistance. Nor will we accept the police occupation, nor will we accept the economic, Kosovo to be an economic colony of Serbia. And I don't think we will accept such a position in the Federation which is offered by Serbia. As a matter of fact, I am very sure nobody from us will accept such a condition, but we will tend to what Dr. Rugova has explained as a full autonomy of Kosovo. The problem is in the further steps. The Serbian regime has put conditions for free elections. It has said that either we approve the constitution and then we go to free elections, or there will be no free elections. If so, Kosovo is again the touchstone of Yugoslavia's quest for democracy. If we do not get free elections by the end of the year, there is a great probability that Yugoslavia will have clashes of greater dimensions and be a very destabilizing factor for the Balkans, not only for Yugoslavia. And if there is shots going to be heard anywhere, then obviously it is here. This is the first place where we should hear. A carrot and a stick policy, which was proposed by some American politicians, I think is the most obvious way to treat the present regimes in Yugoslavia. I am not speaking of one regime in Yugoslavia because obviously we do not have still a federal government. But the measure of economic, political, and all other help from the United States, and obviously the United States does not have a great economic interdependence, but then East, Western Europe will. A great pressure towards Yugoslavia, not only through the economic help, but also through political help in what Yugoslavia tends to do in Western Europe, I think will make this situation clearer, but only to the degree to which such a policy of restraint could not put Mr. Markovic, for example, or the federal government, or the reformists as a whole, under such a pressure where they would have to give. I think we will be of great help for Yugoslav reformists. And I don't think we have had a great support for the Yugoslav reformists yet. And I think they have not understood yet that one of the touchstones of the new Yugoslavia will be obviously Kosovo, and that decision will have to be made in the next few months.
Thank you very much.